is Aarti Phadke, the master storyteller amongst us. She's someone who loves to share stories. Today, Aarti is sharing a story she heard recently at an international webinar, which is an adaptation of a Scottish tale. Let's hear it from Aarti. The title of her story is The Single Story. Over to you, Aarti.
Thank you, Usha ji. I hope I am audible.
Yes.
Namaste to everyone. And I'm going to dive right into the story. So a long time ago, there was a boy named Vishnu. He stayed with his parents and elder sister Mansa. Now Mansa was an adopted child. Vishnu was at the tender age. He was 16. And he loved his sister very much. He felt a strong need to protect his sister, to keep her safe. Not because she was adopted, but because she was a bit unusual. Mansa was quiet. She was shy. She kept to herself most of the times. She sat in front of the mirror and brushed her long curly hair for hours. She was very different from the young girls in the village. The young girls played, sang songs, danced, giggled. And Mansa, she stood by the side, staring at these young girls with her big eyes, not even blinking even once. And in the bright sun, her eyes had this yellow tinge. And then one night, there was a knock at the door. Vishnu's father opened the door, and there was this young, handsome man standing at the door. As soon as Vishnu had one look at this man, he felt very uncomfortable. He did not have a good feeling about this stranger. But in India, we believe Atithi Devo Bhava. A guest is respected as God. So he was welcomed in. The stranger was a traveler. He was looking for rest for a night. So he was served hot food. And Mansa, she served him food and shyly glanced at him. And he smiled at her and she smiled at him. And Vishnu, who was noticing all this, was very anxious. Now, during those days, things happened very fast. So the next day morning, this mysterious stranger asked for Mansa's hand in marriage. The father was delighted because the stranger looked wealthy. And Vishnu's sister Mansa, the shy, the wise, the cautious Mansa, gave her consent willingly for the marriage. Vishnu's heart sank to the pit of his stomach. The marriage date was fixed, and it came too soon. The whole village had gathered for the marriage. Everyone except anybody from the stranger's side. So the marriage took place. And in the evening, as per the custom, Mansa and the stranger set on foot to the stranger's village. Vishnu decided to follow them. In fact, he had even caught hold of a knife to protect his sister. And he tied the knife neatly around his waist. As soon as they had crossed the border of the village, instead of taking the usual route, the stranger led Mansa into the forest. The shocked Vishnu followed them. Now, the forest had tall trees and the branches covered the sky. So it was dark everywhere. Vishnu could not see anything. He could not see his sister and the stranger. But he could hear the sounds of their footsteps crunching. So he decided to follow the sounds. He was very quietly following. He did not want them to see him. And then from a distance, he saw a gleam of silver light. And he knew that there is a clearing there in the forest because the moonlight was shimmering down on the earth. He quickly fastened his steps and moved towards the clearing. He tried to peep in through the creepers to the clearing. And his eyes were just getting accustomed to the light around. Then he heard a sound that frightened him. The stranger
was going big,
and he became a wolf. Vishnu was so scared. He tried to grab a knife, but he flipped it. And then he saw a opposite wolf, his sister Mansa, and she was growing too. And she became a snake. The wolf howled and the snake hissed and the wolf plunged on the snake and the snake curled itself around the wolf. And the snake pierced its fangs in the throat of the wolf. And the wolf fell dead. And what remained was the snake. The snake turned its head towards Vishnu and its yellow light staring at him. Vishnu, she called out. Vishnu was so scared. And then slowly, she became smaller and smaller into the human form of his sister Mansa. She said, Vishnu, your father, the man who raised us, is a farmer. But my father is the king of snakes. He's Nagraj. And I need to go back to him. This beast, he said, pointing at the fallen wolf, was prowling around the village. And he was a danger to you and our parents. I had to protect you and our parents by killing this beast. And now since I've done that, my job here is done. I need to return. Vishnu, you go back to our parents and take care of them. And remember, I love you very much. And always remember that I'm there to protect you. And then she transformed back into the snake and she slithered into the forest, leaving Vishnu staring at her. And that is the end of my story. So I'm just going to take a minute here. The title of my story is The Single Story. It is inspired by Chimamanda Ngozi's speech, The Danger of a Single Story. So it's a beautiful story of the relationship between a brother and a sister. And we just celebrated Raksha Bandhan. So from childhood, we are given this narrative that it is the brother who has to protect the sister. And that creates a single story. And I'm going to quote Chimamanda here, that a single story creates stereotypes. And there's nothing wrong in stereotypes, but they don't project the complete truth. They project only one aspect of the truth. And one aspect repeated again and again creates the only story, the single story. It's time for us to change the narrative. It's time to go beyond the stereotypes. It's time to go beyond the single story. Thank you.
Aarti, that was so inspiring, so inspiring. That's why we would like to call you the master storyteller. Thank you.
Thank you so much.